Grand Prix, sometimes it can be a lot, you know, generic pop songs and love, 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 love. And we tried to get away from that. And I think we succeeded.
Du kigger blidt med en tom fra et billede, som fik en gang, da jeg var dreng. Der er så mange ting, som kører.
Hi, I'm sitting here at the Danish Final with everything taking place very soon. And Emil, you're one of the participants. How did rehearsals go?
It went quite fine, actually. There were some problems with my in-ears, but they were solved, so.
So everything will be ready?
Yes.
Can you tell us how the performance will be?
It will be kind of a relaxed performance. I will be sitting on the scene on a bar stool and playing my guitar, and there will be some pictures on the graphic screen behind me of my grandfather and some nature vibe pictures, yeah.
Moving on to your grandfather, the story is about him. It's a very personal song where you sing about that you wish you had been able to tell him some things. What is it you would have liked to tell him?
Well, I don't think it's a specific thing I would have liked to have told him. It's more like I wish I'd known him, which is the also the title of the song. Because ever since I've been a child, I've heard a lot of stories about him. He died in a tragic car accident. So there's been a lot of talk about that in my family. So I've heard a lot about him. And when you're a kid, a child, and you hear some stories, they often seem very alive. And so I've kind of felt like I've known him, but not known him. Yeah.
And if you're grandfather will be able to see you on the stage, what is it you would like to him to get out of that?
Well, I hope that he's proud and he thinks that's well done, Emil. Yeah.
Okay, if we then go on to talk about the collaboration with the three songwriters, how have that been?
That was a great experience. We met out in Kongelunden in the forest. It was a very hot summer day, so we couldn't stand sitting in a studio in Copenhagen. So we went out there to be in the nature and fresh air and stuff. So that was very nice experience, except for the planes that were flying very low and interrupting us every second minute. Yeah. So
now one of the songwriters is Esben, we have here, and another one is Team Schou, also from a friend in London, which you were part of. Mm-hmm. And then there is this Gavyn, a young American.
Yeah.
Where did he come into it?
Well, Esben knew him, and apparently Gavyn is, well, he is very good with melodies. Mm-hmm. So Esben asked him if he would like to be part of this session with me, and we were going to write a Grand Prix song, and he thought that was fine. He wanted to do that, and Gavyn knows Tim as well, and Tim asked Gavyn, what is it that you're doing that day? And then Gavyn said, oh, I'm writing this song with Emil, it's a Grand Prix song. Oh. Mm-hmm. Then he asked if he could join, and of course he could.
So, if we move on to Esben now, it's been quite some years since we saw you last, yeah. Basically back to 2011.
Yeah.
What have you been doing since?
Oh, I've been doing so many things. I've been recording and producing a lot on my own. I did an EP and two albums for my own project, and I've been touring a lot just with my guitar in Canada and around Europe as a solo songwriter, and I've been on a lot of songwriting camps, and now I'm producing a lot of other artists and writing songs for people in Denmark and in Germany and in the Czech Republic and around the world, and I'm doing an album in Danish now.
Oh, that will be something new. Yeah. So this project you have been going, the Radar Post.
Yeah.
Why doesn't it have your own name?
Well, it actually it used to have my first EPs. They were released under my birth name. But then when I was about to sign, I signed a record deal with Nordic Music Society, and John, my A&R, he said, this music sounds so international, it doesn't sound Danish. So it's kind of weird maybe that it has your birth name. So he asked me to think about a name for the project, and I've had that name, the Radar Post, kind of saved for something, because a radar post is where you kind of observe what's happening and you like send it to someone else, and like you so that's kind of like what I wanted to do with the songs. I wanted to observe things and kind of send it along.
When you're writing songs, for example, last year you had a song in the British selection.
Yeah.
And now in the Danish, have you been submitting to other countries too?
No, not yet actually. But I am working with a band from the Czech Republic right now, Lake Malawi.
Oh, that was last year.
Yeah. I actually think I have. Yeah, I have their T-shirt on. Right. So yeah, I've just been to Prague in January to record two singles with them that I'm producing.
Okay, yeah. Could that result in something for Eurovision again, perhaps for them?
I think they probably won't be in Eurovision again, but I don't know, maybe.
They did take part in the Polish election this year.
Oh yeah, Albert told me. Yeah, you're right. But I don't think they will be a part of Eurovision though.
Okay. If we then focus on this song again, for Emil, have you been able to give him any advice?
Yes. Since actually Emil, he applied for one of my songwriting camps for young talents, and in his application he wrote that his big dream was to be a part of Dansk Melodi Grand Prix. So I already knew that I could help him with that, but I just asked him a couple of questions before, like, do you know like what will happen if you join, and there is some stigma, or there can be some stigma connected to the competition, and do you know what happens if you are going to be a part of it and after and all that, and he just really wanted it like a very genuine way. So I said, okay, that's good, then I can tell you that I want to help you with it. And then then we had the session in the summer of 2019, and I knew that I could, because I've been through the whole circus once, so I knew how I could like support him. I just tried to be very supportive and ask him how he's feeling all the time, and because I know that it has to feel right. And so we've been focusing on just, you know, very natural approach. Mm-hmm. I said we should write a really genuine song about something real, and it should be somewhat organic and a personal song. So that's what we aim for.
Yeah.
And I think when I just saw the test run on the screen, and it just seems like it's all coming together with the visuals and the expression and the song in general and the message of the song. So I think it's very nice.
One last question for you.
Yeah.
What actually happened with a friend in London? Why did you split up?
I think it was just, I just think we had to go separate ways. Some of us, actually it was Ash, the bass player, my good friend, he was the first to drop out and said that he didn't want to do it anymore. And then I was totally, like, my world was turned upside down. And then I started thinking a lot, and then I realized I wasn't happy at all, actually. Although I was living in my big dream of being a professional drummer, but I was just very unhappy. And so I took a month where I thought about it and went for long walks every day. And then I moved back to the countryside to my parents, and I dropped out. And started to figure out what I wanted to do with my life again.
Yeah.
So that's when I started working on my debut album as the Radar Post.
And you feel you're on the right track to finding yourself now.
Yeah. That was actually, although it may sound weird, it was one of the best decisions I made. But I love everything. All the great stuff we did with the tours and the Backstreet Boys and the arena tour, and I wouldn't miss it for the world. But it was just I'm very happy that I moved on.
Will we see you on the stage as a performer yourself for the Danish final at some point, perhaps now that you're also writing in Danish again?
No. I was actually asked 5 years ago they wanted to give me, the Danish broadcasting company, they wanted to give me a wild card directly to the final if I wrote the song and played the song myself. But it feels like that moment has passed for me. But maybe Emil will will come again.
So if we just go back to Emil, so as he was also saying, it's coming together on the stage and it's very personal for you. Last year, it was a very personal song that won the Eurovision Song Contest. This year, you were not selected directly and not by the public out. You were given a wild card after the radio semifinal. Were you disappointed?
A little. I mean, the week up to when we got the news, if we were in or not, I was not feeling so good because there's a lot of pressure and I couldn't sleep and stuff. So actually, when I got the news that I wasn't in, it was kind of a relief. But then we got the news that I was in the final anyways. That was amazing.
How long did you have to wait?
One day. So that was okay.
It at least wasn't because of me, because I live in the North region and I voted for it every day.
Thank you.
But this about being on stage with a personal song, does this mean something extra to you? Does it give something extra?
Indeed. I think Grand Prix, sometimes it can be a lot, you know, generic pop songs and love. And we tried to get away from that. And I think we succeeded. And it means a lot to me that it's a personal song and it's in Danish. So I'm very grateful that they chose my song.
Yeah. There are two other songs in Danish this year. It's actually quite a lot. Are you afraid that you might be stealing points from each other?
I don't really think about it in that way. I'm not really a fan of competition. And my dream was to be a part of Grand Prix. And
but you don't like competition.
No, but I'm in now. And so I'm actually just happy.
And not liking competition, but still wanting to be on the Melodi Grand Prix stage. You up for a second chance at some point?
Maybe. I don't know. If we write the right song.
Maybe yes, we will.
Yes, it could be.
So at the end here, what do you want the viewers at home to feel when they hear your song?
I hope that they will feel that it's a personal song and maybe get touched by it. That's my main goal. So that's what I hope for.
Du kigger blidt med en tong fra et billede, som fik en gang, da jeg var dreng. Der er så mange ting, som kører rundt i ring, og jeg er ved dit sted i ty. Du var der selv, det siger min far. Ville ønske, at jeg også havde kendt dig. For jeg længes efter svar, kan du må se mig oppefra. Føler, at du stadig er her, et sted i mig. Men verden væltede på din vej, og mørket lukkede sig om dig, så du fløj afsted herfra. bare jeg vidste, hvem du var. Jeg ville ønske, at jeg også havde kendt dig. Alle håb, de faldt den nat, hvor alt gik galt, og du drejede fra for sent. Så nu håber jeg, at du kan vise vej, når jeg ikke kan se klart. Jeg ville ønske, at jeg også havde kendt dig. For jeg længes efter svar, kan du måske se mig oppefra. Føler, at du stadig er her, et sted i mig. Men verden væltede på din vej, og mørket lukkede sig om dig. Så du fløj afsted herfra. Hvis bare jeg vidste, hvem du var. Jeg ville ønske, at jeg også havde kendt. Efter svar, kan du se mig oppefra? Føler, at du stadig er her, et sted i mig. Men verden væltede på din vej, og mørket lukkede sig om dig. Så du fløj afsted herfra. Hvis bare jeg vidste, hvem du var. Jeg ville ønske, at jeg også havde kendt. Ønske, at jeg også havde kendt dig. Oh, 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 oh. Jeg ville ønske, at jeg også havde kendt dig.